الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Dear brothers and sisters, we are discussing the sifatul mu'minin, yani features, characteristics or traits of a mu'min according to the Holy Quran and Ahlul Bayt alayhim assalam. And as I have been we have been discussing this topic, we have discussed some of the things, some of the beliefs that we have been asked or we have been required to have. And first quality, the first characteristic of mu'min that we discussed was the aql, and the second that we discussed was the irfan or ma'rifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his own nafs and soul. And inshallah, to continue with the same topic, today we want to talk about some of the qualities of mu'min firstly. And secondly, inshallah, in our Urdu majlis, we'll discuss the benefits of ma'rifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if a person has the ma'rifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are some signs that show that person has the ma'rifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, what are the qualities that we are looking at when we are talking about signs or alamat or sifat of a mu'min? I have gone through many books and I have found a very beautiful hadith of Imam Ali alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. This hadith is very special hadith, because in this hadith, Imam Ali alayhi salam is numbering around 50 qualities, 50 traits and characteristics that a mu'min should have. And as I have told you, that a mu'min cannot be considered a true mu'min unless he possesses these qualities. So if we are lacking these qualities, if we are lacking these traits and don't have or don't give importance to these things, we should consider now, inshallah, inculcating these sifat and qualities in ourselves. Otherwise, our iman or our declaration of iman will be just verbal, and it will not be considered real, because there is a very vast difference between verbal statement and something which is practical. So we have to show some characteristics through our action, through our a'mal, through our behavior, character. And only then we could be considered a mu'min in the eyes of Ahlul Bayt and Aima alayhimus salam. So what are those things? And it is very important that we pay attention to these things. The first thing that Imam Ali alayhi salam talks about is that a mu'min, when he is powerful, he forgives easily. A mu'min, when he is powerful, he forgives easily. So as a mu'min, if a person does not have the quality of forgiving others, he cannot be considered a mu'min. So many a times we have seen that a person, when he gains some power, position, and he has the authority over some people, and the people, for example, cannot do as he expects him to do, he starts doing unjust, being unjust to them. He starts oppressing these people. So Imam is asking us to be forgiving, and not just forgiving easily. So if a person comes to us with an excuse, and we know that it's a valid excuse, we have to be forgiving to this person or these people. Secondly, Imam says, a mu'min, he is soft in behavior. His behavior is soft. When he meets with people, he is not hard on people. And he says, his action and his walking show modesty. A mu'min is a modest person. And then he says, he is ready to bear pain for the comfort of others. A mu'min is a person who does not cause any kind of discomfort for others. No. He is a source of comfort for others. Causing some discomfort or some problems for others he is very far from these things. Far from these things. He is a source of comfort for others. So we should look into these things. So he can go, he can bear some pains for others so that some people might feel, comfortable, feel happy. And this is what we are looking at. And it is called a sacrifice in many cases. And if you look at the kirdar of our Aimma alayhimus salam, we'll see that our Aimma alayhimus salam, when they used to even travel with some other people, they would serve others instead of they expect to be served by other people. And that's why our fourth imam, it is mentioned in the riwayat, Imam Zainul Abidin alayhi salam, he would not travel with those people who know him. He would try to always travel with those people who were strangers to him. So he was asked, why do you do that, O Imam? Imam said, because if I would travel with those people who know me, they would not allow me to serve them. So I want to serve other people, and so I travel alone, or I travel with those people who are not familiar to me. Okay. Now, fifth quality that Imam mentions is that in friendship, a mu'min is pure. His friendship is pure. And his friendship is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he makes friends with others, he does not look at their money, their position, many a times it's something that we look at in other people. We want to associate with those people who are influential, who are powerful, who are wealthy, and so on. But the Imam is saying, no, his friendship is pure. He is friend to anybody who is a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is a mu'min. His criteria for becoming friend is iman, nothing else. He is reliable when he promises. Mu'min is a reliable person. When he gives his word, he fulfills those words. He fulfills his promise. He doesn't break his promise. And it has become a normal practice these days to lie about something that we don't want to do. And we say, okay, it will happen. And inshallah, the word inshallah has become an excuse nowadays. When a person uses inshallah, you should know that this person doesn't want to do it. But it's not like that. Inshallah is, we are misusing it. Inshallah is not for making false promises or giving false words and all that. No. A mu'min does not do that. Imam says, in his judgment, he doesn't oppress or take the part of anybody. And there are so many beautiful stories associated with this part, I can say. A mu'min, when he passes a judgment, first of all, a mu'min is not judgmental. Inshallah, we'll discuss that inshallah later. A mu'min is not judgmental. He does not criticize anybody just for the sake of criticizing. He does not make judgments about others. He does not form his opinions just because he looks at a person he does not like, or his appearance is different from him, and so on. And then he gives his verdict. No, this person is like that. This person is like this. No, it's not like that. Imam alayhi salam is saying a mu'min is not biased. Imam is saying that his judgment, when he gives a judgment, he does not oppress anybody, even his own enemy. And if you look at Imam Ali alayhi salam, for example, there is a very beautiful hadith or a story about Imam Ali alayhi salam. Once Imam Ali alayhi salam's zirah was stolen. His armor was stolen. And I'm shortening this story. His armor was stolen, and Imam Ali alayhi salam saw a person who was not even a Muslim having that armor. So Imam went up to him and he said, this is my zirah, this is my armor. How do you have it? He said, no, this is mine. So Imam said, I will take you to the court. And just imagine, Imam is the Khalifa of his time. At the time when Imam al-Islam is talking to this person, he's the Khalifa. Okay, his Khalifa would mean at that time he was the emperor of, you know, a big empire. You know, because Islam, at that time, Muslims have kind of the biggest hukumat at that time. So Imam is, as a ruler, if you consider, if you see how he is, how he would treat others. He said, I will take you to the court. And then Imam al-Islam took him to the court. And there was this Qazi who was appointed by the Imam himself. And when he saw the Imam, he stood up and he gave the Imam a better position. And he, make this person sit in another place. And then he addressed Imam al-Islam with his title, Khalifa. Or a title, yani Amirul Mu'mineen. And he addressed that person with his first name. Imam al-Islam, he said, "Why? What are you doing? You are doing injustice. You are doing injustice." So he was surprised. This Qazi was surprised. He said, "What injustice that I have done? That I have done?" Imam said, "You are calling me with my title and you are calling this person with his first name. And this is injustice. We are now equal because we are in your court." And then he said, "Give your judgment." So this person, this Qazi, this judge, he gave his verdict because Imam al-Islam did not have any evidence to prove that his zirah is, and he has stolen his zirah, his armor. So he said, okay, because you don't have any proof, so he is the one who has won this. So Imam al-Islam said, okay, you have given the right judgment. And then what happened then when he was a Christian. When he came out of the court and he realized that it was the Imam, he was the Khalifa, authority over all the Muslim Ummah of that time. He said, okay, you are so humble and you are so adil. You are such an adil. You could have taken this just, using your power or anything. You could have called your soldiers and anybody to take this zirah from me. And you are right. This is yours. And then he said, now I become a Muslim. And he recited Shahada because of this amal of Imam Ali al-Islam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. So a mu'min is adil. In his judgment, he doesn't take sides and he doesn't oppress anybody. He is anxious to purify and clear the source of his earnings. Okay, a mu'min, his source of earning is always pure, paak, tahir, halal. He does not want to make money by hook or crook. No, he first looks at the source of his income, where this money would be coming to him. Nowadays, taking some bribe or deceiving others has become a common practice. But a mu'min would never do that. And in fact, a mu'min will sometimes cause some harm to himself, some loss, but he would not allow himself to receive haram money. And then he respects the right of the people in their absence. Respecting someone when he is in front of you, before you, is something not very, big, because a person is in front of you, and if you would be disrespectful to him, he might also, do the same to you in front of you. But if the person is not before you, he is somewhere else, and in his absence you respect him, that is something great, something big. So which Imam al-Islam is saying, is a quality of a mu'min. When he talks about someone, in his absence, he is respectful to that person. Then he says, he accepts the excuse of the faulty. This is a very important quality that we have to have. He accepts the excuse of the faulty. Do you know, many problems that we have in our lives are because of this. Sometimes we see something that we don't like in our house. My child is doing something that displeases me. My wife does something that I don't like. And then they come with an excuse. Imam is saying, when this person who has done some fault comes with some kind of excuse, accept it. Even though you might know that this person is wrong, still you accept it from him. Because this way you will avoid so many problems for yourself and for that person. Okay, if you want to teach a lesson to this person, that is another thing. But if a person, for example, knows that he has done something wrong and he is regretful, then you should excuse him. You should forgive him. You should accept that excuse from him. And it is mentioned in the riwayat that many people would take advantage of this quality of our Aima alayhi salam. And Aima alayhi salam knew that they are taking advantage, but they would say, no problem, I am a soft person. I'm a soft person. I would not, you know, punish you for something small or something that is related to me. He is generous. A mu'min is generous without extravagance and wasting. Mu'min is a generous person. He is not stingy. He is not a miserly person. He gives in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a very important quality. And this is a quality, if you look at the history of Muslims always had this quality. And some other people, Quran talks about them, they were very stingy people throughout the history. And Muslims were the people who would always give in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because by giving, you achieve a kind of, there is a kind of feeling that you cannot by possessing or having. You know, sometimes we see a problem, a person is facing a problem, even in our own family, but we want to keep something for ourselves. Islam says don't do that. Because you may keep that thing for you for some time, but at the end of the day, it might happen, and it happens a lot, that you would not be able to use that thing for yourself only, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the barakat from that thing. Takes the barakah from that thing. And it happens that a person, you know, dies and leaves millions of dollars or whatever, and he has not used that money, and he has not actually used that money for benefiting other people. So this money did not benefit him or others. So a mu'min is a generous person. He is kind and compassionate to the poor and weak persons. Kind and compassionate to the poor and weak persons. Anyone could expect his help in any difficulties. Anyone. The word anyone. So a mu'min does not, you know, just help his own people. No. Anybody can expect his help. And that's what would happen during the time of our Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the mushrikeen would come to the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeking help from him. Seeking even the advice from the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in different matters. And the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would never betray them. He would always help them. And actually this is something that made many of the people of that time Muslims change their behavior, change their, you know, faith because of this kirdar of Al-Bayt alayhi salam. If any person does good to him, he remembers it. هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. So if someone does good to a mu'min does not, you know, forget about it or denies it. No, he remembers it, he acknowledges it. Because these days it's happening a lot of time. You see somebody does good to you and you do the opposite of it. But the Imam is saying, no, mu'min is not like that. If any, he guides those who consult him to get advice. He doesn't disclose the secret of the others. And each and every these qualities needs to be discussed in some detail. But unfortunately, we would not be able to discuss all of them during even the Ashra. Because there's so many. And this is only one hadith that I'm mentioning. There are so many other hadith where Imam alayhi salam has talked about the signs of a mu'min, alamat of a mu'min. Inshallah, we'll discuss those alamat slowly and gradually, inshallah, in coming lectures. He is honest and trustworthy. He avoids force, ignorance, and lies. He mixes and he is good-tempered and kindly. He isn't cruel and rude towards his inferiors. So inshallah, if you look at these, this is a lesson for humanity, all the human beings. If we could inculcate these sifat, these qualities in ourselves, these qualities are going to profit us, benefit us, not only in this world, but also in the hereafter. And if we have these qualities and we live in any society, people will look up to us. People will, and this is what our Imam alayhi salam, Aima alayhi salam have always told us. They have said, Kunu lana zayna, wala takunu alayna shayna. Be an embellishment for us. Be zinat for us. Do not be a source of humiliation, source of insult for us. So if you're living in a society, you should have these sifat. And by having these sifat, what would happen? That that people of that society would come to you and ask you, who are you? I have never seen such a person who has got so many good qualities. You know, and especially in the West, if you are good, people, you know, appreciate it. Probably in our societies it might not happen, but here they see, if especially Muslims, each and every Muslim is an ambassador of Islam. And especially people look at a Muslim, how he is behaving, how he is carrying himself in the society. So these are some of the qualities that Aima alayhi salam wants us to have. Inshallah, some of the other qualities we'll discuss in the coming lecture tomorrow. But before that, I would like to mention an ayah from the Holy Quran. And this ayah says, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضُ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. I mentioned one ayah yesterday. We discussed that. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ. The mu'min are those when the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned in front of them. وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Their hearts tremble. This was the ayah that we had discussed yesterday. Today, I want to discuss another ayah. But this ayah is talking about some of the very important qualities which mu'mineen should have together. And they should help each other in having these qualities, these sifat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in this ayah, he says, but the faithful, the mu'mineen, men and women are comrades of one another. Awliya'u ba'din, ba'duhum awliya'u ba'd. They are friends of each other. They are helper of each other. They are supporter of each other. In what? In practicing their religion. So Allah says, يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. So mu'min, they bid what is right and forbid what is wrong. This is a very important quality of mu'mineen. the Muslim society, you will see people doing Amr bil Ma'roof and Nahi anil Munkar. And one of the reasons we are drifting, and in our Muslim societies, we are drifting into a lot of problems because of this. We have left the Amr bil Ma'roof and Nahi anil Munkar. When we see something bad happening in the society, evil taking place in the society, we should raise our voices. We should call it evil. If we stop doing it, then that evil practice will become normal, something ordinary, acceptable in the society. So if you see something bad, especially in the Muslim society, among the Muslims, you should point out to that person that this is evil, this is bad. And there are marahil, there are stages of doing Amr al-Ma'ruf and Nahi al-Munkar. Inshallah, we'll discuss those in coming lectures. So this is first quality, يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ according to the Holy Quran. And then he says, وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ Mu'mineen are the people who establish salat. They are very particular about namaz. They are very particular about salat. They give a lot of importance to the salat. And قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ We will discuss that also. When we will talk about ibadat of mu'min. A mu'min is a person who is an abid also. He serves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, yuqimuna salah wa yu'tuna zakah. Mu'min is a person, mu'mineen are the people who give zakat, charity in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa yuti'oon Allah, they obey Allah wa rasulahu and his prophet. Ulaika sari sayarhamuhum Allah. These are the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant his mercy, shower his mercy upon these people. In Allah Azizun Hakim. Indeed, Allah is Almighty, all wise. So if you look at the Holy Quran, we recite the Holy Quran very carefully, we'll see on each and every page of the Holy Quran there are some messages for the mu'mineen, and these messages must be obeyed by all the muslimin, because as I have already said in my previous lecture, that these qualities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about in the Holy Quran are not just to be read or recited with beautiful voices. No, they have to be put in practice in our kirdar. They should show through our kirdar, we should show it to others, and this will be good for us, for the society, for this world and the hereafter also. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.